Hey, have you ever had your desires change over time? Hi, I'm Jeff. This is Java with Jeff, and I have my beverage and my Bible. Hope you do too. And you know, my desires have changed over time. When I was in high school, I wanted to be an architect. And so I took every architectural design class I could throughout high school. I had independent drawing my senior year. I was headed that direction. This is back in the late 80s, before computer animated design, CAD, had come around. And so we had just gotten that into the school. It was kind of fun. You got to see a marker draw out the front of a house. But I was headed that direction. And then God changed that in college, and I wanted to be a teacher. Went from architect to teacher. My desires changed. And I was student teaching in a Christian school, and I thought that God was leading me towards teaching and coaching. And then I went on a short-term mission trip to Romania, and God changed everything. My desires changed again. I have told the story before, but two things happened. I was falling in love with a girl on the trip that would end up being my wife, and God was calling me into full-time vocational ministry. And so my desires changed over time. My passion for Jesus increased, and that's how it played out for my story. Your story is different than my story, but when you start aligning Jesus being number one in your life and being the most important focal point, everything changes. Even your career can change if you start to do that. And it happened in Paul's life, the apostle. So you remember Paul. Paul went from being a persecutor of those of the way of Jesus, of Christians, of followers of Jesus. He went from that to, well, on the Damascus Road in Acts chapter 9, everything changed for Paul. A 180 degree change. He was transformed and his desires changed. He went from Pharisee to follower of Jesus overnight, went on three missionary journeys, wrote letters back to churches, helping them see that Jesus was alive. He risen from the grave. And a good summary of this happens in Philippians chapter 3, starting at verse 7, where Paul says this about how his desires, his passions shifted. But whatever is to my profit, I now consider loss for the sake of Christ. What is more, I consider everything a loss compared to the surpassing greatness of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord, for whose sake I've lost all things. I consider them rubbish, that I may gain Christ and be found in Him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness that comes from God, is by faith. I want to know Christ and the power of His resurrection and the fellowship of sharing in His sufferings, becoming like Him in His death, and so somehow to attain to the resurrection from the dead. Wow! What a mouthful of Paul saying that. You know what? Everything that I was doing before, my resume that was being built, all the accolades I got for being a Pharisee have changed. I consider them rubbish or garbage or the town dung heap. That's what Paul would say about everything else compared to knowing Jesus. So when you do that, when you rearrange some things, have your desire to be for Jesus, then everything else falls into place for you, including your career, including your future spouse, including your raising your kids. Everything rearranges when Jesus is first. I hope that's encouraging to you. Paul's life was transformed. I pray your life's transformed too, so that you'll rearrange your desires, your passions for Jesus. Until next time, be encouraged today. What do you need to do next to rearrange a few things so that Jesus is number one first in your life, so he's the number one passion of your life? I'm working on it still. I know you are probably too, but I hope this is encouraging to you. Until next week, take care.